These sun blaster light bulbs totally saved my plants this winter. We had so many gray days. Beautiful Super 7 couple. Palm trees never did well in my house. This one seems to be very happy. And this little palm tree is still alive. Some of my crystals. My daughter. Who doesn't love an alien face made out of calligraphy stone? Look at him, he's beautiful. You'll soon be at the south window. As will he. Pothos is trying. Skulls. They're beautiful. Love my crystals. It's my newest and biggest ever monstera leaf. It's absolutely humongous. Looking out the window. It's a variegation. This has to be repotted once I can find more soil. My new lucky bamboo. It was hard to find. And this beautiful peperomia aquamarine. My prayer plant isn't doing so hot. It may be time to give it a trim and let it start over. And my Ripsalis. I'm hoping she will bloom soon. Those little red dots, where are they? I will let you know when she flowers. My lovely little Ripsalis. Not Ripsalis. This is a Hoya. Hoya retusa. And when it blooms, it gives you one flower. It's grown since I've gotten it. Pretty little thing. Then we have this baby. Koya Linaris. Growing so well. Which takes me down to my lovely prayer plant. And oops. And I didn't have any blooms on it when I got it. And one day, I touched the leaves and told it how much it was loved. And now we have one, two, three, and four. My hibiscus. She's going to bloom again. Beautiful salmon color. Lots of blooms here. Here. Sorry for the backlight, but this is my string of hearts, and she just loves to live everywhere in my living room. And I mean everywhere. Another Ripsalis. I like the funkies, and it is funky. And also up here, right over to this sunblaster is my Scandapsus pictus. It's growing like wildfire. And it comes from the plant here that's on the absolute other side of the window. And because they are my favorites, what do you know? Another kangaroo foot fern. And back here, if I can avoid some backlighting, is my gorgeous donkey's tail. And it's growing below the pot now. I can't wait till it grows to the floor. This one is my peperomia hope. I have difficulties with most peperomias, but this one is more like a succulent, so she's done well with me. Beautiful girl. And she hangs nice and low as well. And new growth, of course. And back here is my, what is it? Hawaiian tea plant. Brand new. And my beautiful Raphidophora tetrasperma. It's grown so much, I'm going to have to add another piece to the moss pole. Philodendron Saluma. And behind that, you can see it. It is my Monstera Edisonii. My lucky dollar tree has grown lovely. As my Chinese evergreen has too. Is this a Scindapsus pictus, I think? No. Philodendron. Philodendron, and it's a... Oil and Maris trying to start some. Philodendron Lime. This is my beautiful whatever it is plant. Watch chain. Huge Haworthia. And another pothos. And this is another turtle vine. I have some of my favorites on this shelf. More crystals. My absolute favorite is smoky quartz. My little turquoise, not turquoise, it is, oh, what is that called? It is called a amethyst mushroom. And my amethyst Buddha. My fluorite. It's beautiful. Another amethyst. I forget this stone's name. I love my pillars though. Some quartz. Beautiful golden band in it. You see that? My chakra books, another philodendron, and my three brand new Wally grows full of Marble Queen pothos, and I can't wait till I cover the pots and then it'll be down the wall. I hope you enjoyed. I forgot to show you my little turtle. Focus. There we go. And next to him is my dragon's head. My dragon's skull. And you need to see this pretty little turtle. Moss agate. Slow and easy wins the race, right? I hope you enjoyed this video. It was very impromptu, but my plant certainly did survive the winter. And I do believe it has a lot to do with the sun blaster light bulbs that I used. This was the first winter I used them. And I hope you enjoyed seeing my crystals.